All right, it's still TVC Breakfast, and now let's talk about the APC convention. The ruling All Progressives Congress, APC, might have successfully held its national convention without breaking up like many predicted. The party still has much on its plate to handle.
And that involves reconciliation. Now, while Delta and Imo State delegates engaged in a free-for-all at the convention, some party stalwarts stayed away from the event altogether. Now, before that convention, the APC was struggling to address the grievances of some party members in different states. Now that the convention is done and dusted, the party is now faced with the Herculean task of reuniting its members, a challenge the party's new national chairman says he is ready to face head on.
I am aware there are challenges here and there, but I believe the team that have just been elected, we have what it takes to address those challenges. The instruments required do not require rocket science. Basic commitment to the provisions of our constitution, commitment to democracy, internal democracy, mutual respect for each and every one of us, purging ourselves of any arrogance, and a commitment to honestly listen, discuss, persuade, and find common ground so that in the end we can have a win-win solution in any of the states in which we have challenges.
Okay, the new APC chairman there, Comrade Adams Oshomole. All right, we have an APC member, Adeboye Kale Jaye, right here with us in the studio. Good morning and thanks for joining us.
Good morning and good morning, viewers.
Yes, okay, so it's a new day for the APC, you would say, but that new day comes with a whole lot of things on Adams Oshomole's plate. He says he has what it takes, he knows what the problems are, and he's going to face those challenges head on. Talk to us about that, first off.
Well, I like to say that peace is never in absolutism. When you have peace, you must be also be in search of true peace. And in search of true peace will also tell you that there are challenges ahead. So war in itself is also not in absolutism. Those who go to war end up on the round table. And those who are in peace may find themselves in a war situation. So having laid that foundation that way is to say that there cannot be absolute, complete, total, uninterrupted peace in any political party. Because party is about interests. And interest is about articulating your own position and trying to sometimes lord it over others or persuade others or convince others or intimidate others into believing in your own principle and ideologies.
Yeah, but the real challenge is how does it rub off on the overall interest, on the national interest as opposed to personal interest. When the president, President Buhari, made his speech at that convention, Oshomole and all the others who, you know, the top leaders who made their, you know, made speeches at that convention, including Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, one singular thread that went through all their statements was, it's time for us to move away from selfish interest and think about the national interest.
Yes, and that's why we must also appreciate the position of all the leaders of the APC. They have come to accept that we still need more reconciliations, that people definitely are aggrieved, no matter how a minority they may be. It's also to say that it's a party that has made up its mind to ensure that we can ensure that everybody is in our fold. And in doing that, you had the commitment of the chairman of the party, you had the commitment of all the leaders, and of course, all one will hope and pray is that this is pursued rigorously, without any outer of doubt. If this is pursued, some who are aggrieved will definitely come back.
All right.
And some may choose not to come back.
All right. It is not lost on anyone that there are individuals who are aggrieved within the party. Talk about the NPDP, for instance. Of course, leading to the convention, there were insinuations that some of them may not be present at the convention, but we did see some of them at the. My question is, even though that they attended, do you think all is well now?
Well, I do not think that all is well in absolutism. I keep using the word absolute because you cannot have all of those one in totality. So, but then no matter how it is very clear that APC has come up as a united party. Majority will have their way, minority will also have their say. It's also to say that we acknowledge that we need to do more work. But then even as we do that work, as we reconcile, we can only reconcile the reconcilable elements. The irreconcilable elements.
Like what now? What would be the reconcilable and the irreconcilable elements?
Yeah.
What would those be in specific terms?
In specific terms, it's to say that those who feel that perhaps their interest is not protected sufficiently well in APC may want to seek solace somewhere else. And in seeking solace somewhere else, they are also going there to meet some other challenges. So whether the rich becomes poor or the poor becomes rich, poverty has come to stay. There is no place you go to. Either party A or party B or party C, there are intrigues, there are challenges, and you have to live by it. So nobody, my advice is to say that we must remain to forge ahead and make APC stronger than it were before and ensure that we can collectively draw the political agenda to further develop our nation, to further alleviate poverty, to further ensure that we have better security, to further ensure that the people of Nigerians have value for dividends of democracy.
Those three points that you've just raised now, the issue of security and, of course, the challenge of poverty, are major things that Nigeria is facing now. Nigeria, incidentally, has just overtaken India as a country with the largest number of poor people. 87 million of 190 million people are now poor, below the bread line. And then you have the issue of security. Or insecurity, as it were.
How did we get to where we are today?
Yes.
We always must also apply the principle of ultimatism to say that when you look forward, you must also look backward. Though the degree at which you look backward is also the degree at which you look forward. But then you cannot close your eyes and feel that nothing went wrong in the past. How did we get to where we are today? A 16 years of PDP rule in this country has plunged us into all of this that we're seeing today. And of course, the new government tried to straighten out things. You can't have gain without pain. You can't, because it's except you have pains, that's when you have relief. So we had those pains coming up as bad luck from the PDP misrule.
But sorry to interrupt you, sir.
For today,
have there been indications to show that there have been some measure of relief? Because the way it seems at the moment, it does appear that things are nosediving consistently. Does it appear that there are some measure of relief in your
I don't agree with you that we're nosediving. God forbid that PDP government had continued after that 16 years. This country will have come to a state of comatose because things were at the brink of collapse when they were leaving. The naira had fallen beyond expectation. And then you also have situations where the treasury had been so looted. We saw a lot of looting evidenced by the circumstance that we saw after they left. So what will have happened is for us that would have gone into a state of comatose. But then when you want to repair and rebuild, it takes much longer effort. It takes much more challenges. So I also say it very emphatically that there had been progress in this country.
Okay, let's...
Poverty definitely is not in the same index that you have. Forget about what international communities are saying. Have they forgotten that where were they when all of these things were happening. They are collaborators in siphoning our resources. All the stolen wealth, where were they going? Where have they kept into? How much have we been able to repatriate all of those stolen wealth? Where, who are those? Who are the beneficiaries of misrule in Nigeria? Is this same international community?
Well, that's the first statement. But then again, let's even move away from that and look at the way forward for the APC. Kwankwaso, a top person in the APC, was not at that convention. A few of others who were not there, people like Dino Mela, he actually called that convention a joke. Say Awada Keri Keri, that's how he actually described it. And Oshomole has said, look, I know what it takes to move the APC forward. Between now and 2019, when the general elections, I mean, it's right around the corner. How quickly can Oshomole actually deliver on reconciling all the, you know, aggrieved parties to ensure that truly that the APC before 2019, way before 2019, will become one party, united and indivisible, in spite of the you know, mild crisis, differences or crisis that might be there?
Yes. Which one would you have preferred? Mm-hmm. Some stayed away. Let's talk about hypothetically about 10 people were expected at the convention, and you have 9 people at the convention. Somebody was not there hypothetically. Mm-hmm. And then which one is should be of more concern to compare with a convention that was held and people at the convention walked out of the convention and massively moved out of the convention and said the convention was
a failure.
A joke.
What we had in APC, I was also there. I was at the convention. I was a delegate. I was a voter. Mm-hmm. And I witnessed all that happen. I saw some level of, you know, orderliness. I saw some level of, you know, of cooperation. And what we're saying is that no matter what you think about what happened in the APC convention, it's still far better than what we had in previous conventions.
Yeah, but can that reconciliation happen?
Reconciliation now, like you have said.
Yes.
The reconciliation is possible.
Okay.
For those who are really ready to be reconciled.
All right.
And that's what I talk about, reconcilable elements and irreconcilable elements. Mm. For those who have made up their mind to leave the party, no matter how much you persuade them, because they can't have their wishes attained and achieved within the structure, they may still want to leave. But okay. Oshomole has given a commitment, and all the leaders of the party have given a commitment to bring everybody on board. And that's what will happen. Mm-hmm. And the process is to say that Oshomole leading the ESCO must also have a talk, a dialogue, a meeting with all of these aggrieved people and see what are their grievances and see how much you can tolerate, you know, some of these grievances and let the APC move forward.
Okay, we'll have to leave it there, truly. Deboye Kanejaye is APC member. Thank you very much. Thank you for looking still very much patriotic in spite of the loss yesterday.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.